Hello everyone. Today I am going to discuss about AC to AC converter. Here we can take example of a fan regulator. If you want to increase the speed of fan, then increase the input voltage. And if you want to reduce the speed of fan, then decrease the input voltage using regulator. But in earlier days, you might have seen a large size regulator were there. In that regulator, the voltage was not controlled. Instead, extra voltage is allowed to drop across a resistance. Because of that one, I square R loss takes place across the resistance. So too much heating takes place across the earlier regulator, and to cool down, proper ventilation is required. Because of that one, the size of regulator was large. But using AC to AC converter, we can control the input voltage. That is better, instead of dissipating heat across the resistance. So this AC to AC converter is more efficient than earlier regulator. This is just one example. There are various examples of this AC to AC converters. And one of the demerit of this converter is that you will not be able to control the frequency. For that, you have to go for cyclo converter. So let's start. If a switch is connected between AC supply and load, the power flow can be controlled by varying the RMS value of the AC voltage applied to the load. And this RMS value of AC voltage is controlled by controlling the firing angle or switching pulses. And this type of power circuit is known as AC voltage regulator. Applications: industrial heating, on load transformer connection changing. Sometimes in on-load transformer connection changing, we need to change the tapping of the transformer, and that can be easily done using this AC to AC converter. Then light control. Intensity of light you can control by controlling the voltage, and that will control the current. Then speed control of polyphase inductor motors. Now, generally two types of control are used. First one is your on-off control, second is phase angle control. So let's start with on-off control. Here you can see AC input voltage is connected across a bidirectional switch and a load resistance is connected. This is a bidirectional switch because when the input is positive negative or positive half cycle, then thyristor number 1 will conduct, and when the input voltage is at its negative half cycle, then favorable condition is there for thyristor number 2. So in on off control, for some duration of time, complete cycle is allowed to appear across the load. That means you can say positive or negative half cycles are not controlled. Number of complete cycles are allowed to appear across the resistance. Then after that, this supply voltage is disconnected from the load by turning off these two thyristors. So from here you can say the thyristor number 1 is triggered at 0 degree. That means it will give complete positive half cycle, and thyristor number 2 is triggered at 180 degree. So complete negative half cycle you will get. So like this, 0 degree, 180 degree, 0 degree, 180 degree. So number of cycles you will allow to appear across the resistance. Then as per our requirement, we will remove the firing pulses from this thyristors so that current through the circuit will be 0 and the voltage will be 0. So this is your on off control. That means for some cycles this switches will be on, and for some cycles this switches will be off. So please note, it is not half cycle fiery angle control, it is number of cycles we are allowing across the load. Now why it is done? You can see this type of control is used in applications having high mechanical inertia and high thermal time constant, industrial heating and speed control of motor. If the size of the motor and you can say the mechanical inertia of the motor is very large, then by applying number of pulses this motor is started. When the motor reaches at its rated speed, then the supply is removed, and because of inertia of the motor continue to rotate for some duration of time. This saves enough amount of power. Then again, when the speed reduces, the input voltage is applied across the motor to regain the rated speed. Likewise, industrial heating. Suppose you want to heat a furnace up to 1000 degree centigrade, then by applying input voltage across the furnace to reach 1000 degree centigrade. Once it reaches 1000 degree centigrade, then the supply is removed. As the thermal time constant is very large, so instantly the temperature of the furnace will not decrease to lower value. So it will take some time, or up to allowable limit the temperature is allowed to decrease. Then again the input voltage is applied across the switches to heat the furnace. So like this it will continue and it will save lots of energy. Let's see how this on-off control works. This is our input voltage. Now for some cycles this input voltage is there across the load, then for some cycles this input voltage is 0, then again the input voltage is made available to the load, as I have discussed in case of industrial heating or motor control. Now how this input voltage is made available to the load? You can see here this is our input voltage. Suppose this is the 0 point. So at 0 point we are giving the firing pulses. So this positive half cycle or thyristor number 1 will conduct for 180 degree. Then at pi this firing pulse to SCR number 2 is given, then it will continue in next 180 degree. Then again this firing pulse is given at this point, positive half cycle and negative half cycle. So like these firing pulses if you will give, then input voltage will appear across the load. And here you can see these gate pulses are removed, so the thyristor are not triggered and the output voltage is not appeared across the load. So the output voltage is 0. Again the firing pulses are given and the input voltage appeared across the load. So let's assume that for n number of cycles pulses are available across the load, and for m number of cycles the pulses are not available or input voltage is not there. So this is your pulse number 1, then it is cycle number 2. So for n cycle our input voltage appears across the load, and for m cycles we can say it is absent. Just like any other converter, here we can say the input voltage is on and here input voltage is off. So the duty cycle is equal to on period divided by the complete time period. So from here to here is our complete time period, and from here to here it is our on period. So we can analyze this output voltage waveform based on these parameters. Let's see. Input voltage is Vm sin theta. This input voltage is Vm sin theta. This one is also Vm sin theta, but for n cycles only. So the input voltage is connected to the load for n number of cycles and is disconnected for m number of cycles. Then the RMS output voltage, we can write, find the RMS output voltage for one cycle first. So it is 0 to 2 pi Vm square sin square theta d theta. Then multiply it by n number of cycles, as it is 1 for n number of cycles. Then divide it by complete time period. So complete time period is equal to m plus n into 2 pi. Then you will get Vm by root 2 square root of d, where d is equal to duty cycle is equal to n by n plus m. So like this we can find the RMS value of the output voltage, and by controlling the duty cycle or by controlling the number of on pulses or number of on cycles, we can control the output voltage. That's why we are saying it is a AC voltage controller. Now one of the advantage of this one-off controller is that due to zero voltage and zero current switching of SCRs, the harmonics generated by switching actions are reduced. Here you can see, whatever input voltage we are giving, exactly same input voltage appeared across the load. The reason behind it is that at zero point, you can see this, at this point the voltage is zero and the current is zero. So there is no effect of switchings and the harmonics across the output voltage is reduced. At the same time, losses across the switches also reduced. So it is zero voltage, zero current switching. If the load is resistive, then it is zero voltage and zero current switching. So this is one of the advantage of this on-off control. So today I have discussed about AC to AC converter. We have discussed that for n number of pulses, our AC output voltage appeared across the load, and for m number of pulses it was off. So by controlling the number of cycles appeared across the load, we can control the RMS output voltage, and then we have found out the RMS output voltage of this AC to AC converter. Only on-off control method today I have discussed, and we have found out that because of zero voltage and zero current switching, harmonics across the output voltage is reduced. At the same time, switching losses are reduced. So it is one of the efficient converter used for industrial heating and motor speed control. Next class, I will discuss phase angle control of AC to AC converter. Thank you.